Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is the introductory video about the playlist Power BI Report Server. In this video, I'm going to talk about the purpose of Power BI Report Server. In upcoming videos, we will try to cover how to install it, how to configure reports in Power BI Report Server. With this note, let's begin. Before going into Power BI Report Server, let's try to understand what is the two versions of Power BI servers available, right? So this is the typical flow as part of Analytics with Nags or any YouTube channels. They publish only on the cloud. Like, they create reports in the desktop. You can publish reports in the Power BI services. This is the Power BI services, which is on the cloud. Then you can consume the report. There is another separate route or the way of creating or sharing the reports, which is called Power BI Report Server, which is you are seeing at the bottom, where you will create your reports in the Power BI desktop, which is designed specifically for Power BI Report Server. Then you will publish your reports in the on-premise report server, Power BI Report Server. Then you will be collaborating with your users. These is the two different flows of report sharing and collaboration, or the report development lifecycle. So this is what I want to clarify. So one is on the cloud, another is on-premise. So now you got overall idea what is the Power BI Report Server. Then you might have a question, what is the purpose of this? So basically, like, the main purpose of report server is like, you have your data to be stored on-premise. That is the main agenda behind your on-premise server, keeping your data on on-premise. Because the industries like banking or military or any government organization, they don't want the data to be shared on the cloud. Even though it's a Microsoft or Google, whoever, it's a reputed companies, they trust on the data security, all those parts. They don't want the data to be stored on cloud. If you see in our previous architecture, you create a report, your data is stored on the cloud. Even if they say it's a private cloud, they don't trust the service provider companies. They want the data to be securely stored on their server. Because this server, whatever you are installing, Power BI, this is owned by the government organization or a banking company. So their data is securely on the server. They protect this server on top of multiple securities, right? So this is the main agenda or the purpose of your report server. So your data is stored on cloud, I mean on-premise. Basically, the report server is hosted in your own servers. Then your data in turn obviously stores in the on-premise. That is the idea behind it. So the Power BI Report Server is similar to SQL Server. Those who have worked in SSRS, it is more or less same like report servers, and also it combines Power BI Online Services. Why it is said like this? Because the Power BI Report Server can hold or host or can store Power BI files, that is .pbix files, as well as RDL. The SQL Server Reporting Service extension uses RDL. Then it combines both. It can be able to store both. Even Power BI Online Service stores the both. So this is the beauty of it. So this is one of the advantage of Power BI Report Server. Like, it combines Power Reporting Services as well as Power BI Online Services PBIX file. And Power BI Report Server features are superset of reporting service. So people, those who are currently using Power BI SQL Server Reporting Service, they can upgrade to Power BI Report Server. They can host their existing SSRS reports as well. This is for just for information. But there is a huge difference between Power BI Report Server and Power BI Online Services that I will cover it in the upcoming videos. So as I said, this is just an introduction video. So what we are going to see as part of this playlist, this is the introduction and purpose just now we have seen, and licensing. Next, I'm going to explain licensing in the next video. Difference between Power BI and on-premise, that I'm going to cover, and setup report server, and installing Power BI Desktop for Report Server. Power BI Desktop is different for report servers. That's what I specifically had a single topic for it. Then there comes how you can develop, deploying and configuring dataset, page generated reports, RLS. More or less it is 80% it's same like creating reports, but once you publish into the services, slightly it differs from configuring dataset and reports when it comes to RLS, all other stuff. So these things we will see in as part of this playlist. I hope you clear with what is the main agenda of this playlist. Let's talk about the free content available in this channel. This channel contains $1,250 or 100,000 INR worth, and it covers Power BI and SSIS, SQL and SSIS, and you can utilize this free content. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.